This is a brief video tutorial demonstrating for you how to reorder and make visible and invisible the course navigation links. So you can see over here to the left are all the course navigation links. Okay, all of them right now are visible except for announcements. And then you will typically see, if you see an eyeball next to, or now eyeball with a slash next to the tool, it means that it is either A, you have not created your first, or B, you've made it invisible. And so I'm going to show you how to reorder and then how to make those links visible and invisible. So you're going to come over here to settings. And then by default, you'll land on your course details here. And so you're going to click the third tab in navigation. Okay. So now you have all of these that are at the top are those that are visible. And then all these that are at the bottom are invisible. Okay. And you can simply drag and drop them to the top to make them visible, or you can click on the canvas stoplight, these three dots, and click enable. Now, for your students, you need to think about the fewest links possible. You want to control the access of content. As you'll learn, modules is really the best way to approach student access to content. Okay, so you're going to leave that always visible. You cannot change the home button. As you can see here, there's no canvas stoplight dots to be able to move it, or because it always stays in that default position. But I want to disable a few of these because I want all of my students to funnel through modules. Okay, so for instance, I'm going to leave announcements because I will probably, there may be some announcements that I post, so I'm going to leave that. I'm going to leave discussions because there may be a specific discussion like a cafe kind of thing, like a water cooler kind of thing that's open all the time for your students to comment on. So you may want them to access it through discussions. Now, if I didn't, I can simply disable by clicking the dots and saying disable. I want grades to be available so my students can see that. Syllabus will be available. Google Drive, the Google Drive that's listed here relates specifically to the end user's drive, okay? So you won't need to make that invisible. Monitoring reporting is for you as a teacher. It helps to look at the data that you sync back from your gradebook in Canvas to your gradebook in Power Teacher Pro. You may want to leave badges if you have created badges to where students are creating or satisfying module requirements, they earn badges. The rubrics keep visible. It's only for you. Your students will not see that. Okay, that's going to be one that the students will not see. Attendance, students don't see it. Only you see it. Okay, so you won't need to make that one invisible. So I'm going to disable Screencast-O-Matic. I'm going to disable files. I'm going to also disable outcomes. I'm disabling conferences. I don't need, unless you need these now, of course you keep them. I'm going to disable collaborations, quizzes, pages, assignments, and people. Now you may want to say what are the ones that you really ought to disable? I would think pages, files, assignments, quizzes, and possibly discussions, because you're going to actually build all of those pieces into your module so that you're funneling them to your module stream. All right. Now, if I wanted to reorder this, for instance, I think me taking attendance is going to be important. So I'm going to move it up to the top. I also want my syllabus to be close to the top for my students. And then I'm going to put modules right after that. So I've kind of built around these the specific order that I want my students to see this in. Okay, so now you always got to make sure that you hit save. If you don't, it's not going to take. Okay, so I'm going to hit save. And so now you will see when I go home, you'll see the order in which I reordered everything. Attendance is now at the top. And then all of these that have the eyeballs with a slash is because those are now invisible. Okay. Hope that helps your understanding in how to reorder and then how to hide and how to make invisible the course navigation links.